FDA and CDC now say that people can get boosters that are different from the vaccine they originally received. So say you got the Pfizer vaccine 6 months ago, you can now get the Moderna or J&J booster if you are eligible to do so. Our Nixon Norman tells us more about how this new recommendation of mixing not only allows for more immunity, but also accessibility.
Okay. So the FDA and CDC approve of mixing vaccine brands. But what are local health experts saying?
We follow the scientific information on the subject. We follow the guidance of the FDA and the CDC in terms of what is allowable for the mixing and matching of doses.
Well, they seem to be following suit, and they say with good results.
And what I'm really telling patients is that, first of all, mixing and matching is allowed. There does appear to be good data that it allows for a good response post-vaccine.
This new recommendation allows people to choose different vaccines for their third dose or booster shot. So now, no matter what vaccine you got for the first round, whether it was Pfizer, Moderna, or J&J, you can choose whatever kind of vaccine you would like for your third dose or booster shot. Not only does this bring more immunity and choices to the table, it also allows for more access to vaccination.
I also think that the practical issue of ensuring that people who are qualified for boosters can get those.
When it comes to supply of vaccines, we are definitely doing better than we were, especially when they first came out. But there are still places that may not have access to all three brands. So again, mixing further allows for those who want to get vaccinated and boosted to do so, even if their primary dosage brand is not available. Nixon Norman, Fox 54 News.